let's say that we know that they're similar. That's important, that we know that they're similar. If we didn't know that, we wouldn't know a lot. We wouldn't be able to figure out much. So right now, could you tell me, just knowing that this is 3 by 5 and that this is a scaled up version of that rectangle, could you tell me like how long this side is?
15.
Can you tell me for sure?
No.
Can you guess?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Of course you can guess.
15.
Let's say we guessed it. We guessed it was 15. Okay, let's say it was 15. Well, now that I know that for sure, can you tell me how long this side is?
Yes.
Yeah.
How long?
Yep.
Nine.
So someone describe to me like what's the whole process going through your head, Kelly?
Well, from what it looked like, it looked like the size went up by three.
It looks like what?
The size went up by three.
Size went up by three. So could you say that you did 15 divided by 5 is 3?
Or you could just divide from 3.
Okay. So you're asking yourself what do you multiply by and just figure out that it's 3?
Yeah.
Okay. And so that tells you that.
Times 3.
That I should also be able to multiply this by 3. That's the way similar figures work. If this side gets multiplied by 3 and they're similar, then this side gets multiplied by 3.
Yeah.
We talked about this last time. What's the area of this rectangle?
15,
right? Because we have 3 rows and 5 columns. You go right there. So altogether there are 15 what?
Squares
that fit inside here. Right? And this rectangle is 3 times as big.
135.
Okay, so we got momentarily tricked last time, but we're not falling for it again.
Nope.
Okay. What's the trick that we're not falling for? That the area of this is, Cody?
3
times bigger. So we're not falling for the trick that this would be 45. Right? This is not 45.
What's the trick?
Like if you,
I don't know what you're saying.
I was trying to trick you yesterday or Friday into thinking that if these sides are 3 times as long as these, then the area is also 3 times as big. But it's not. If you were to fall for the trick, you would say, oh, that's 3 times as big, so multiply this by 3, the area of this is 45, which is not. What is the area?
135.
Okay. How many times bigger than 15 is 135?
9.
9 times? So you multiply 15 by 9, and you get 135.
Yeah.
Well, what did we multiply the side lengths by?
3.
We multiply the area by what?
9.
See any connection there between 3 and 9?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What connection do you see between 3 and 9?
Times by 3.
Times what by 3?
3.
3 by 3 is 9.
Yeah.
3 times 3 is 9. Okay. Let's erase all that. Okay, we'll leave that 3 by 5. Let's say this is the long side on this big rectangle here is 45. Okay. If you want to feel like you're behind and you don't understand, just continue to look at things other than what's going on the board. How many times bigger is this side than this side?
9.
Okay. So this whole rectangle, right, should be 9 times bigger. So how long is this side?
27.
Where's my finger? Okay. Let's do that. 27. The area of this is 15. We're not thinking that this is just 9 times bigger, right? How big is the area of this rectangle?
Hold on.
You got it?
No, but I have something to say about vexillology.
Jeez.
Okay,
1,215.
I was watching Big Bang Theory this weekend,
jeez,
and they were talking about it.
Vexillology?
Yeah.
So
tell us about it.
What were they talking about?
Sheldon was making tutorial videos on what that's
called. He's having a pretty good day.
Mrs. Stewart,
no.
Oh, no.
You got it? 1,215?
Yep.
Okay. Is that 9 times bigger than 15?
Yep.
Yeah.
Or no.
No.
How many times bigger is it?
Twenty, wait, no.
Twenty-seven.
Twenty-seven times bigger?
No.
Bigger than that.
Probably like 45.
You think it's 45 times bigger?
Yeah.
How do we figure out how many times bigger it is?
You buy it.
Times.
45 times 15 and then if it equals 1,215, then yeah.
I know.
I don't know, 45 times 27 equals 1,215. I hope.
It's 81.
81, Nicole?
You could divide, 1,215 divided by 15 and you get your answer.
Which
it's
is?
It's 81.
Which is 81.
Which is 81.
Nicole.
So we multiply this by, so we multiply 5 by 9 and 3 by 9. What do we multiply the area by?
81.
81. You see the connection between 9 and 81?
Yep.
What is it?
9 times 8 is 81.
And we just say a second ago 3 times 3 is 9. Right? When the side lengths were multiplied by 3, the area was multiplied by 9.
Oh.
Oh, I get it now.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh,
the side lengths are multiplied by 9, the area is multiplied by 81. Let me see if I can show you why it's multiplied by 81. Okay? Before I show you anything, I'm just going to say this side's 9 times longer than that one, right?
Mm-hmm.
This side's 9 times longer than that one. Okay, let me show you that. Let me show you 9 of those, if I can. Let's see, break it into 3, break each of those into 3. Okay, I just tried to, as best I could, take this 45 side and cut it into 9 pieces. Did okay. So how long is this right here?
5
is that?
5 by 3.
Well, so far I just know that this
five.
Is 5.
So how many of these do you have?
Okay, so let's cut this into 9 pieces, because this is 9 times bigger than the short side of the small rectangle. Divided into 9 in an okay way. How long is this side?
3.
3.
3. So how big is this rectangle?
15.
Well, the area is 15. It's how big this rectangle is, right?
Yep.
Just one of those right there. How many of these rectangles can I fit along this side right here?
9.
How many can I fit this way?
9.
So 9 of them can fit there that way, right?
Yeah.
So like a row of nine of these, and I can fit 9 of those rows. How many of those rectangles can fit in there?
81.
81 of those rectangles can fit in there. Just one of them has an area of 15. This side's 9 times longer. This side's 9 times longer. So we have room enough for 81 of those original rectangles. That's why when we multiply, when we scale it up by 9, the sides multiply by 9, but the area multiplies by 9 times 9. 9 times 9. Let's try this, see if you're up for this challenge. What if?
It's a challenge.
Oh, challenge.
Let me clear all this out of here because I don't want it to get confusing.
Shut up.
Hey. Let's not be so rude to each other, please.
Yeah, tell you.
Okay. Let's say I multiply this side by M for multiply.
Killing.
That wasn't me.
So if I multiply this side by M, how big will this new long side be?
5m.
Okay. Well, if this is m times bigger, and this is a similar rectangle, then how big would this be? 3m, because I'd also multiply this by the same thing. So what would the area be multiplied by? 2m? Close.
15m squared.
M squared is what I would multiply this by. Because it's M this way and M this way. So the area of this would be 15 times whatever M squared is. When it's 9, this is 81. When it was 3, this was 9. If this was 7, this would be
14.
Seven and 49.
49.
So if the side lengths were 7 times bigger, the area would be 49 times bigger. Because it's 7 times bigger times another 7 times bigger. It's 7 times bigger in two directions. So we get the square of that number. What's the perimeter of this rectangle? The perimeter of this small rectangle. What's that?
15.
How'd you get that?
5 plus 5 plus 3 plus 3.
So this side must, of course, this is how rectangles work. 5 and 5, this is 3 and 3. If you had 5 plus 5 plus 3 plus 3, 16. That's like if you were to just walk around the whole thing, you would walk 16. So the perimeter of this one's 16. What's the perimeter of this one?
16.
16 squared. 16 m squared. 16 m squared? Mm-hmm.
I think it's just
16 m. 16 m?
Yeah.
16
m.
Because
we're not talking about area.
We're not. What are we talking about?
Perimeter.
Which is what kind of a measurement? Not an area. It's a length. Right? So here's another way to look at it. This length here, I'd measure with like a ruler, right? I would also measure the perimeter with a ruler, okay? So when I multiply ruler measurements, okay, then all the ruler measurements are multiplied by the same thing. So if it's multiplied by n to get this length here, my bay, m to get this length here, the perimeter is the perimeter just m times bigger. Let's see it with specific numbers. This rectangle is 2 by 7. I'm going to clone that rectangle. Make it bigger, make it 21. Okay. So this side's 21. How long is this side then?
6.
Gotta be 6. Because they're both, how many times bigger?
Three.
3 times bigger. This one's also 3 times bigger. You're not paying attention, not being part of the class. You're working your way towards not being part of the class. Which means you're working on your way towards leaving. You'll start writing the angle again soon. Okay, so this length is 3 times longer, this length is 3 times longer. Okay? So the perimeter should be how many times longer?
Three.
Let's just test it out. What's the perimeter of this guy here?
18.
14 plus 2 plus 2. 18 is the perimeter of the small rectangle. The large rectangle we're saying is 3 times bigger. Okay. Rather than just trusting our instincts to say that the perimeter should be 3 times bigger, let's add it up. 21.
42.
6. 42.
15.
Plus 12.
54?
Mm-hmm. Is 18 times 3 54?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did we do it? Did we multiply it out?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It is.
No.
18 times
3. Yes, it is.
It is.
54.
Question.
Wait, so, how is the perimeter 18 instead of 14 inches? Oh, gone.
This is not new today or yesterday. 14, right? 7 plus 7 plus 2 plus 2.
14 plus 4. 15.
7 plus 2 plus 7 plus 2. The perimeter is just the measure all the way around. 14 and another 4 more. 18.
Oh, 14.
Oh,
we're going to
7 plus 7 is 14. Plus 2 is 16. Plus 2 more.
18.
18.
Oh, yeah, for area.
Okay, so when we scale up or scale down a similar figure, okay, we're looking at similar figures, we scale it up by multiplying the side lengths by a certain multiplier. So 7 times 3 gives us a rectangle that is scaled up by 3. It's 3 times bigger. Okay? And everything that you can measure with a ruler is 3 times bigger.
Yeah.
Or 5 times bigger, or whatever that multiplier is. So this side length is multiplied by 3, this side length is multiplied by 3, the perimeter, which also would be measured with a ruler, is multiplied by 3. Okay. And in any other thing you might make up that you measure with a ruler about that thing will be multiplied by 3. Okay. But what's the area of this rectangle? The area
14.
Of this rectangle is 14. What's the area of this rectangle? Is it 3 times as big as this?
No, it's
9 times bigger than that area. So what's the area of this guy here?
126.
126?
Yeah.
Because 14 times 9 is 126. Let me show you again. Why, when we multiply the side lengths by 3, the area gets multiplied by 9, okay? For every 1 inch here, that's 3 inches over here. For every 1 square here, that amounts to 9 squares over here. See that? Let's split this side into 3. Right? Just took this side length of 21 and cut it up into 3 pieces. So if I cut it into 3 equal pieces, then how long is this one piece right here?
7.
And if I cut this side into 3, then one part of it is how long?
2.
So this little guy here is the same as the original rectangle. So just as much area fits in here as fits in this original small rectangle. And by looking at it, I can see that I can fit another one there, another one, right? I could fit 3 across the top here. I could fit 3 more here. And I could fit 3 more along the bottom. How many of those rectangles are in this big rectangle?
9.
Yeah. 3 this way by 3 this way, 9 of those rectangles. So this area is 9 times bigger, where the side lengths are just 3 times bigger.
Mm-hmm.
So we've talked about this just a minute ago. If I take the lengths, lengths are things that I can measure with what kind of an instrument?
Ruler.
A ruler. Measure lengths with rulers, meter sticks, right? These straight lines. Okay. If I multiply the lengths by 3, as we did in this example, then the area gets multiplied by how much?
9.
Okay. Now length measurements, measurements that I can measure with a ruler, that's length, width, height, base, whatever you want to call these measurements of the rectangle. Perimeter, right, is another one. So that'd be perimeter, length, width, base, height, whatever we call it. Anything you measure with a ruler gets multiplied by 3. The area, since it's a length by a length, a ruler by a ruler like this, I actually get 3 times 3 of those. So it's 9 times bigger. If I were to multiply the lengths by 5, what would the area get multiplied by?
25.
25. Because this side would be 5 times bigger, this side would be 5 times bigger, and we could fit 25 of those rectangles on the large rectangle. Okay. And if the lengths are measured by, or multiplied by m, then the area is multiplied by
3.
Squared.
Oh.
By m times m, right? 3 times 3 is 9. 5 times 5 is 25. M times m. M squared. That's just the shorter way to write m times n is m squared. One last time. We'll try and figure it out before I say anything. So I'm going to give you a side length. You figure out the other side length. Okay? So figure out the other side, you're going to figure this other side out. You're going to figure out the perimeter.
What?
Okay, so the perimeter of this guy, perimeter of the new one, and the area, of this guy. So you're going to figure out the area of this guy. You're going to figure out the perimeter of this small one. You're going to figure out the perimeter of the large one, the area of the large one. All I'm going to give you is one thing. I'm gonna give you how long this is.
Yeah.
And say that it's something different. 36.
Smooth math.
Does I mean like without knowing anything else about this rectangle, you can have the area. So what's the area of the small rectangle?
45.
Alright. Are you serious?
Shut up.
Wow.
I didn't know we were raising hands.
45. Because 45. What are there 45 of that fit in this
squares?
Squares. 45 squares. Because if I can do this even moderately okay. Right? 9, it measures 9 this way. And it measures 5 in this direction. This is the hard part. So I can see, like, there's an example of 1 square, 9 this way, 5 this way, 9 columns, 5 rows, 45 squares can fit inside there. Okay. What's the perimeter?
28.
Make sure you're not mixing up the area and the perimeter, okay? The perimeter, the thing I think of, which I'm trying to think of a real world time, that somebody says perimeter, it's like a, I don't know, some fugitive has escaped, and the police are trying to find this person, and they say, let's set up a perimeter around this area, right, to try and keep this situation under control. The perimeter is the outside. All along the outside. If someone were to walk the perimeter of this rectangle, how far would they walk? They'd walk 9 and 5, then another 9, and then a 5. They'd walk 2 9s and 2 5s. 28. 18 plus 10. Okay, so we know that so far. Right now, at this moment, could you tell me the perimeter or the area of this rectangle?
Yeah.
Not quite.
No, because you don't know the other side.
You need that side. So, what is this side?
20.
How do you know that, Mac?
Because I divided 36 to 9.
36 by 9 gives you 4.
4.
Which tells me what I need to multiply by to get from 5 to this guy.
4.
5 times 4 is 20. Okay, now do I have to measure the perimeter again for this thing? Couldn't I just take this perimeter, and then I know what this perimeter is? How big is this perimeter compared to this perimeter?
Bigger.
How much bigger?
Way bigger.
Four times bigger.
Four times bigger.
Yeah.
Right? A side length is 4 times bigger. Perimeter is a measure of side lengths, right? All added together. So if all these sides are 4 times bigger, then if I add up all of the sides, they should be 4 times bigger than those sides added together. So how big is this perimeter?
112.
Yay.
Now
whether you add it all up or you take this times 4, you get the new perimeter. What's the area of this?
720.
Do I have to do 36 times 20 to find 720?
Yes.
Not necessarily.
Oh,
okay. It will do it. It will tell me 720.
It'll be easy.
But also the area, this is 45. Right?
Yeah.
And how many of these rectangles will fit into this big rectangle? 16 of them.
Mm-hmm.
16 of them, because this is 4 times bigger than 9.
Oh. Okay.
And this is 4 times bigger than 5. So look what we have here. This is a 9 by 5 rectangle. And you can see that there's room for 4 by 4 of them. There's room for 16 of those. 45s. 16 of them. So the lengths, the side lengths get 4 times bigger, the area gets 16 times bigger. Let's have a recap of this problem that we did. Okay? We got all the way done with it, but I just want to recap it with some different numbers. Doesn't look as good as it did yesterday, but or Friday. All right, let's say this is actually like a kid. This kid is 4 feet tall. Okay. Should that height of that kid help me in finding how tall this tree is?
Yes.
Why?
Not at the moment.
Not at the moment, but if we kind of establish a few facts, it should. How do we use similar shapes to solve this problem? What similar shapes did we find?
Triangles.
Similar triangles.
What?
Okay. Where is one of those triangles?
The shadow.
Now, the shadow is not a triangle. Shadow.
I know.
Okay. Jasper, from the tip of the tree to the tip of the shadow to the bottom of the trunk.
So down, okay, so here to there and there. That's a triangle.
Yes.
So that, and this, and a triangle. Okay? And where's another triangle, someone else?
The one behind the kid.
Top of the tree, but not the trunk. Whoa! Yes,
top of the tree, but not the trunk?
Yeah.
Like right there?
Sure.
Well, we probably want to get a triangle involved with like other objects in this problem. Maddie?
The one standing to the point.
So there, that doesn't look any different from color. There you go. So from here to there to there. Okay. Now this wouldn't really help us to notice that there's two triangles unless the two triangles are similar. Okay. They're not congruent. They're not the same size. But this big triangle is like maybe it's 10 times bigger than this small triangle. Right? Is that true?
Could be.
It could be. How can we be for sure that this triangle is just a bigger version of this small triangle? The kids like the tree, but smaller, right? This tree standing straight up. This kid's standing straight up. So 90 degree angle, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well that's one important part. This is a 90 degree angle, and so is this. If we have some more shared angles, then well, we'd be pretty sure that triangle is the bigger version of this triangle. Are any of the other angles in these triangles the same?
Nothing.
Can you show me at least one other one? Like convince me one other one is the same.
One next to the kid's head.
Right
that
in the corner.
The top of the tree.
And why do we feel like that's the same?
Because they're both at the top of the kid's a smaller version of the tree.
Yeah.
And the angles near the top of his head, then you know it would be the same on the tree.
We've got this straight line that's coming straight across both the top of the tree and the kid's head, right? And unless it like bent down or up like that, it would have to make the same angle because they're both standing straight up. And of course, this angle is the same down here because the two angles in those two triangles are right in the exact same place. This triangle is lying right in the same place as the angle in this bigger triangle. So they definitely have all the same angles. Okay, this is a different angle, so we use kind of a double. So they definitely have the same angle there, there, and there. So they're similar triangles. That works for triangles. Okay. It doesn't work for rectangles, but it does work for triangles. They have all the same angles, so they're similar. So I know they're similar. I know he's 4 feet tall. Is that enough to tell how tall this tree is?
No, sir.
No, just like we needed with the rectangles, we need to know more about the side lengths of these two triangles. So what else can we measure about these triangles?
The angles.
The bottom.
Well, if we knew some trig, we'd be in shape, but we don't know any trig. We don't need any trig. The bottom, what bottom of what?
The tree.
The triangle.
Do you think trig?
The tree.
The shadow.
The shadow. From here to the tip of the shadow. If we knew that, that could help as long as we know how big this shadow is too. Like their shadows should be like scale versions of each other almost. So let's say that his shadow is 7 feet and the shadow of the tree is 56 feet. Is that enough to tell how big that tree is based on how tall this kid is?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could take...
Why is that?
Those two times each other.
Those two times each other? You got this small triangle and this larger similar triangle. The base of this one is 7. The base of this one is 56. What does that tell us about the large triangle to the small triangle?
That the bottom is 8 times bigger than the small one.
So it's 8 times bigger. So how many times bigger should the tree be than this kid?
8
times bigger. So how tall is this tree? What's that?
32.
32 feet, because I multiplied this by 8.
Oh!
How do we get 8?
Because you divide 56.
56 divided by 7 is 8. Sometimes 8 is 56.
Yeah.
What's that?
What's the 7 of
it? 7 is how long the shadow is.
Oh.
56
well,
is how long
see.
The tree's shadow is. So this is 7. This is 56. 56 is 8 times bigger than 7. Since we showed by these angles, the angles being the same, we know these two triangles are similar. Meaning one triangle is just so many times bigger than the other. And we figured out that it's 8 times bigger. The base is 8 times bigger, so the height should be 8 times bigger as well.